The miniature C208 Bravo Grand Caravan EX aircraft is presented to Secretary Gilberto.
The Secretary of National Defense, the Honorable Gilberto C. Teodoro Jr.
It's nice to see familiar faces, even though some people you cannot see, just the uniform you can see. Anyway, today we witness another piece of solid and concrete evidence of the partnership and the alliance between the United States, our treaty partner, and the Philippines. We will see more exchanges as the days come, not only with the United States, but with other countries of like persuasions as well. The platform you see here is an ISR platform, which will contribute, no doubt, to our command and control and our ability to protect whatever mission area is critical to us at a particular time. The Chief of Staff, the Commanding General earlier stated that hopefully it will contribute to national peace, peace in our land. However, as we think, peace is truly important, but it is one of our national security goals. Another national security goal, which is of paramount importance now, is the ability to secure the territorial integrity of our country, to secure our sovereign rights and our jurisdiction for two things. Number one, we are upholding a rules-based international order and international law. And number two, national peace cannot be sustained if we cannot secure our sovereign rights in these areas which rightfully belong to the Filipino people and our successors. And so we begin this leap today. Because we have international law, the law of nations, and the interests of the Philippines in mind. And I encourage everyone here to literally think the big picture now, because our scope of operations has definitely increased. And we have to secure our archipelagic baselines, because our existence as an archipelagic nation means nothing if we cannot secure our baselines. Secondly, as I said, the 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone and other areas. And because of the fact that we have international law and a rules-based international order, which includes freedom of navigation and an international airspace, as justification for what we are doing, we hear a chorus of nations supporting us, a chorus of countries, because we are in the right. And this right track that we are taking resonates throughout the world. And hopefully, this piece of evidence of convergence today in our interests, our common interests with the United States, would also translate into more action, convergence actions between us and like-minded nations. So we thank the United States once again, and we thank our leaders, our planners, for converging our efforts towards upholding the rule of law in this part of the world. And national peace is one goal, as I said. But the Philippines is a vital potential vital contributor to regional stability and security if we are a strong nation, a strong country with a strong armed force. And that's what we are working very hard to achieve. Because if not, then our integrity, and our prosperity as a country is severely compromised. But with you, with us, working together, I'm confident we can achieve it. So maraming salamat po sa inyo, mabuhay po kayo, and a pleasant good morning to each and every one of you.
We have to validate it because according to the arbitral award, that is a violation of an international treaty, no? The destruction of maritime life, particularly if the coral destruction is a cause of or used for reclamation of artificial islands, etc. Now, we have to validate it, and then we'll coordinate with the Department of Foreign Affairs so that we can file the appropriate action.
This week, sir, from the Navy, then yeah. Now we are in the Air Force. Put emphasis, sir, on how we are modernizing, but at the same time, you said kailangan to look it over. Nakasama natin si Chief of Staff, sir. You mentioned last time that you had ordered a review.
Yes.
Also to look into how our programs ito can complement our existing programs.
Yes.
How is that, sir? How is it going so far? And then, given the security landscape that we're facing, kano critical that we do this review now?
Critical ngayon because of the fact that the sooner we wait, the sooner mas mabagal na matapos ang review natin, mamahal ang mga gamit, and we have to build up our capabilities as soon as possible. So this cannot be delayed. And we are working day and night to try to establish our own systems and whatever capabilities that we can get from our treaty partners and other allies. We're trying to converge these into interoperable systems. It's critical, highly critical that we get it now.
Is there a timeline for that, sir? When the review can be done, and then how soon can...
Perhaps by the end of the year. By the end of the year, because it will include even where we are going to establish our bases from our then the capabilities, and then it will include also, because if you increase capabilities, you will increase your funding requirements also from Congress. Even though, for example, this platform is donated, we have to appropriate more funds to maintain and operate it in an optimal manner annually. It will be used for all operations, all types of operations,
including po sa WMS.
Yes. Yes. Chief of Staff is here. If you want to ask him questions, or General Parel.
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yes, definitely. This aircraft will boost our capability of patrolling our maritime seas. And as mentioned by the commander of Western Command, si Vice Admiral Carlos, our ability to protect our sovereign rights in our exclusive economic zone depends highly on the equipment that we have. So definitely, this aircraft will help us, will boost our capability in making sure that we secure our territory and our sovereign rights.
A list, sir, no, early on for Horizon 3 and Horizon, parts of Horizon 2, and then the SND is asking us to go back to the drawing board and reassess the needs. That ano yung nakikita niyo mga major changes, sir, in terms of what we'll be proposing for funding, sir, na mga modernization?
Well, the Secretary of National Defense ordered also not just the re-horizoning of our modernization program, but to look really into our strategy, you know, of defending our country. So now we're looking at a change in our strategic direction when it comes to defending the archipelago. You know? Kaya yung ating modernization program will also depend on that shift in our strategy. This time, we are focusing on really projecting our defenses to include the 9 features that are being occupied by the Philippines. All right, thank you. Salamat. Si Jibab.
So anyway, sir, ako lang na lang. Kung wala si Eric, sir, hindi natin siya maantay. Ma'am, nawalan doon, ma'am, sa likod. Sir, ganito na lang. Yung sinasabi, sir, ni SMD na growing board, sa in terms of sa PAF, sir, magkakaroon ba ng reprioritization ng mga acquisition ng assets natin, given that mas malaki ang marami ang nire-request ngayon na mas malaki ang security landscape na kinapakoverser sa
ating. Definitely, that has to be evaluated, no? Because depending on the evolving threat, we also have to have capabilities commensurate to the evolving threats. So it has to be evaluated if we have to tweak the capability development program that we will be pursuing. Kasi useless kung we stick to our plan and yet it cannot address the evolving threats. So definitely, that has to be rethought.
A question from Mr. Eric. How will this program, sir, help the Air Force in performance mandate?
This brand new aircraft is a very welcome addition to our intelligence surveillance and reconnaissance capability. It will also boost our capability in missions of law enforcement, terrorism, and maritime domain awareness. Sinabi kanina ng ating SND that it will be used for all types of missions depending on the need. And during humanitarian assistance and disaster response, this aircraft will also be useful, particularly sa aftermath ng disasters on Ardana mission, so that we could assess the damage during calamities.
Sir, kailan ang possible first deployment nito?
This will be deployed immediately.
Saan?
Yeah. Wherever it's needed.
Needed po sa WPS, sir, possible po ba doon?
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.